Hey guys.
I'm Bree. I'm going to talk a little bit about trans identities and how they intersect with like tech spaces. No, I think it just won't play through the speakers. Yeah.
It's...
Oh, sure. Yeah. I'm Bree. I'm going to talk a little bit about trans identities and how they intersect with being in like tech spaces and in progressive and feminist spaces. So I think most of us, when we think of oppression and marginalization, tend to think of it as something that like other people do. In particular, we think of it as something that like particularly like archetypically bad people do. So it's easy to think of like racism as being committed by like the Ku Klux Klan and homophobia as being committed by like the Westboro Baptist Church. And I think it's sort of interesting that we do that. I think it is sort of based in like being able to other people like that sort of makes it easier to share an identity of like, okay, I'm against that. They are over there. I'm over here. And you know, it makes for a good conversation occasionally. But I think what's harder to do, and what's maybe a little more ambiguous, is to sort of call out and discuss the endless little streams of microaggressions, that we all commit, sort of daily, and that marginalized people just sort of face constantly. And so I am a queer trans woman who is pretty visibly trans also, and so most of the, and otherwise pretty much privileged. So most of the stuff that I face has to do with like gender identity and sexuality stuff. So for example, like the biggest thing with me is misgendering, right? There's like this constant little trickle. There's actually... there's a great little blog post that like compares misgendering to Chinese water torture of just like the like day-to-day little drip of like these little slight, you know, maybe individually annoyances that like over time or with like a few particularly awful instances can sort of just like reduce you to a wreck pretty easily. So I wanted to talk a little bit about those and I guess, how you can recognize them, how you can call them out. So first, I want to talk a little bit about my transition, just so you guys, I think, have a feel where I'm coming from. It feels really weird and vain and narcissistic still a little bit to talk about my transition as part of this talk, but I think it's really important to, to get an idea for where I'm coming from, maybe to like have some kind of connection with a trans person if you don't, sort of get an idea of how that narrative is not the pop culture one necessarily. And also because this week is my 1 year mark for HRT, so I'm kind of doing it for myself, so you know, no big deal. Oh no, please don't. No, it's cool. So I'll try to keep this brief. I don't want to give like my entire life story here, but in brief. So at like 23 in 2013, I had been feeling like these vague, uneasy gender feels for like a decade or so that were sort of hard to define, and sort of over the course of 6 months, a year, very gradually came to. Like the understanding of my identity as a woman. And again, it was very gradual and that it was very necessary for that to be gradual. It was sort of like, well, I'm a guy who likes to cross dress. I'm a genderqueer person. I'm a trans girl, but I really don't feel like identifying myself as a woman publicly, et cetera, et cetera. Transitioning in that gradual process was actually fairly easy. The hard part was actually coming out to people, because for that period of time, it was like, I don't know what to come out as. Once it's like, okay, I'm a lady, like, that's pretty easy to explain to people, but if you're coming out as, like, I'm a genderqueer person who, like, identifies somewhere in the middle of a spectrum, and it's like, most people don't even have that maybe baseline as to like, what you are trying to tell them. But so at work, eventually I sent this email out. It's long-ish, so I won't read it out loud, but it's just like, hey, just so you guys know, I prefer the name Bree and female pronouns. And yeah, if you look at the bottom, I made a really dumb naming stuff and cash invalidation joke. So that's cool. yeah, and so part of the reason I put that there is because, and I will, obviously this will be posted up later, but I put that there because a lot of, like, when I was looking for a model for how to do that, like how to send that email out, I had nothing to go on. I would really like if more people had some kind of format for what to go on. There were like a couple of things, but it's just, it was very difficult for me to find something. So it was actually a pretty smooth transition, all things considered. Like, I had very supportive coworkers, partners, my family was great. But even like a smooth transition is one that's pretty peppered with awful crap. And so there's one instance that, like, I think kind of sticks out the most, which happened, like, I don't know, 4 or 5 months into transition. I was at a bar here in, like, East Atlanta, and we're standing outside, and two guys come up, like, who've been passed by. One comes back and says, oh, hey, guy, I'm sorry, me and my friend were talking, we were wondering, you're actually a guy, right? And, like, I was just, like, I didn't even know how to respond to that. I think I just said fuck off really loudly and, like, sort of pushed him. And didn't really know what else to do. So I was like, okay, this was a gay bar. I went around back. I was like, that's some rando. I will hopefully be a little safer around the back of the gay bar where, like, the actual patrons are. So then within, like, the next 20 minutes or so, two more guys come up and start hitting on me, but then say, like, oh, hang on, wait a minute. I'm gay, so I'm gonna make sure you're really a guy, right? Like 3 times in a row, this question. So, you know, by that point, I'm getting pretty visibly upset. Someone asks me what's going on. I tell them what. I tell them that people keep asking me, like, I'm actually a guy, right? And the person I tell this to is like, well, you are, right? So I ended that night at Waffle House, which is a pretty good way to deal with that, if you're wondering. That incident sort of started me thinking, like, why do people think it is okay to say these things? Why do people think that these weird little microaggressions are, like, totally fine to just come out of their mouth and not really consider the effect that has on people? And so I sort of ended up compiling, like, a list of, like, here's all these shitty things that have happened to me and other people I know. So that's really fun, by the way. Set aside some me time after that if you're going to do that for yourself. But yeah, I sort of ended up putting it into a nice big rule of three pile. And so, you know, until recently, the biggest piece of it is just sort of ignorance. Like, so many people don't know the language, don't know pretty much anything about trans identities. And so that just leads to lots of weird stuff, like just implicitly misgendering people because you don't know that trans people can exist and that men can look a certain way, women can look a certain way that is not the way that you're used to. So, you know, there's sort of the, like, excuse me, you're in the wrong bathroom sort of situation, and just lots of stuff like that. The biggest example is, have you had the surgery? Don't ask this to someone if you don't know that already. Because what you're actually asking is, hey, what's your junk look like? I really want to know. Don't do that to, like, anyone. So thankfully, this is getting a lot better. There's been a lot more, like, pop culture awareness of trans people through, like, Laverne Cox and Janet Mock and Laura Jane Grace and all of these people. And that's been great. So it's reducing this a little bit. And, you know, the answer for yourself, if you feel like you are doing this kind of thing, is to read up on trans issues and, like, I don't know, read a book, read Redefining Realness. It's great. And just read things by trans authors, things like that, and, I don't know, sort of get an idea of where they're coming from. So that pop culture thing, though, has a flip side, which is a lot of people tend to start looking at trans people through, like, cliches. And the big one here, right, is like the tragic trainee, which is like, you're so brave. Don't tell people that either. That's also weird. Like, I might beep if I hear that again. It's weird to tell someone that they are brave for having the identity that they have. I think the way to get past or through this one or whatever is just sort of to lift the voices of trans people. So again, like, there's a lot of things there where like people will come to be friend of a trans person because the cliche is that it is very shameful and anxiety inducing for a trans person to be trans in public. So like, they'll go up to a friend, or a lot of times people will go up to my partner. And so I never got the has she had surgery yet question, but I did get has she had surgery said to my partner a lot and then told afterward, and it's like, what? Why is it more okay if you tell them? That sort of thing. So just lifting the voices of trans people, being like, hey, talk to this person, or, you know, recommend these sources, these books and whatnot by trans people, rather than speaking for them, so that you can sort of kill those cliches. So the big one that I need to talk after is sort of just the fundamental denial of, you know, in the case of trans women, their identity as women, trans men as men, non-binary people as non-binary. Just sort of the like absolute failure to recognize our existence as the identity that we say we are. And so, I made a nice table. So here's sort of how that plays out in language. There's always, cis folks get a default and trans folks get a modifier. So a lot of language until recently was like, you know, you would say, what are your preferred pronouns to someone who is like maybe visibly trans or something? But you don't say preferred pronouns to anyone else. You just say, what are your pronouns? So people identify as something, trans folks self-identify, so there's a lot of stuff that's like, hey, self-identified women, welcome, that sort of thing. That's sort of odd because it's not a modifier that you would use in other cases, it's just like, women, welcome. So it's odd to say self-identify to just mean, if you are a woman, come to the space, that sort of thing. I built that big table, and I'm sort of trying to get this point of large numbers of tiny events affecting us. I guess to make it clear that like there's a lot of work. It is like a staggering amount of work that needs to be done to improve this situation, and it is large enough that like it needs to be undertaken by like every single person actively. And not just like, I'm aware that this is a problem, but in like calling these things out, in having the uncomfortable conversations with your friends that like, hey, the thing you said was awful, here's why. I don't really have any tips for actually doing the calling out, but I would appreciate if anyone wanted to comment with them. That's it. Thank you.